death by marijuana. The first report is now on the books, but to be honest, it all seems a little suspicious. Hey everyone, Laci Green here for DNews. The first reports of a death caused by marijuana are circulating out of England. Her name was Gemma Moss, she was 31, and reportedly collapsed and died after smoking a half a joint to help her sleep. She was ruled by a British pathologist as well as a coroner to have died from cannabis poisoning after they found moderate to high levels of THC in her blood. They found no other issues with her organs that could have explained the fatal heart attack. Surprised? I'm no pro at the effects of cannabis on the body, that would be Trace, but the idea that someone could die from smoking a half a joint sounds sensational, if not intentionally misleading. With almost a week since the news broke, scientists from around the world are weighing in and calling the ruling absurd and ridiculous. A study published in American Scientists, which built on decades of medical research, found that in order to overdose on marijuana, you would need to smoke 1,000 times the amount that it takes to get high. That's like a third of your body weight, which is why death by marijuana has been declared virtually impossible by some scientists and has never been documented before. So could this be a case of new evidence of the dangers of marijuana? Or is it just a politicized report on the tragic story of a young woman who just happened to have smoked a joint before her untimely death? Scientists at Icon Medical School in New York say that the story would have been more viable scientifically if the joint had been laced with another drug, but it wasn't. Psychopharmacologist David Nutt, who's gained esteem as a no BS scientist in the world of international drug policy, says that the report of death by marijuana is dishonest and likely obscuring the true cause of her death. He suggests it could have been caused by an underlying cardiac condition that Moss had without knowing. It's also known that she was very depressed, which raises the risk of sudden cardiac arrest. Dr. Nutt believes it's possible that the small additional stress on her heart from the joint may have been the straw that broke the camel's back. And he notes that this kind of cardiac attack has been triggered far more commonly in sports, having sex, sitting in saunas, even going to the bathroom. The jury's still out on what actually happened, and given that the claim is so extraordinary, there's certain to be further investigation. But either way, it's a tragic situation for her family, I'm sure, and I can't imagine it's much comfort that her death is now caught up in a controversial battle about the dangers of marijuana. So what do you guys make of the report? Let me know down below, and we'll be back soon with more science updates.